All right, chapter 8.
You're going to have to pay for that.
Maybe you're not okay. Ah, he lives. Finally awake, are we?
You're...
Aerith. It's Aerith. And you are?
Cloud.
Nice to meet you again.
Again, huh?
What? You don't remember? What about the flowers?
Oh.
Also all those ghosts, but also the flowers.
An old church in the Sector 5 slums. You came crashing through the roof without so much as a lookout below.
Cloud's like, actually, I'm an atheist.
Lucky for you. Like, really?
Sorry, I didn't mean to...
Don't worry about it. They're a lot tougher than they look. This place, it has a kind of power. Before I forget, you dropped this when you landed.
Thanks.
I've got one, too.
Okay, get ready for
you
this.
And everybody and their mother.
Not like mine, no. It's special.
This part is gonna blow Chris's
Mine's
mind.
Not good for anything at all.
Watch.
That's right.
That's right. They did it.
Oh, come on.
Tom's, I'm sure Tom's like, what? What was that? That's like, that is like the biggest thing. That's the biggest thing that happens in this whole video game. Like, they couldn't resist.
Jeez. You guys.
Tom, I'm still trying to figure out why she thought this was such a good spot for her flower bed inside of a collapsed building.
It's got a special power, didn't you hear?
They cannot be getting enough sunlight or rain.
Well, that's the magic of this. A Rufus! Not Rufus, the other guy.
Reno.
Finally, it's
Turks.
Cool
one of the Turks is a Turk.
A Reno.
Finally, some cool guys.
Reno, thank you. Or judge.
Great, now I have to edit it. Cool, huh? All right, 44:59. I'm going to write that down.
My bad.
It's all right.
You've got the eyes, at least.
You don't mind, do you?
It's beautiful, beautiful baby blues.
Tom, I don't know if she said it here. I was too busy getting mad. the flowers in the original game, the magic was that the flowers somehow grew when there was no sunlight there, essentially.
Oh, so the magic was love.
Exactly. The power was Aerith, I believe.
See, yeah, I'm just going to cut to the chase.
Judge is correct. The power of Aerith. Did you understand what we all reacted so poorly to
flashback?
What is your guess?
If you're gonna bullshit me, at least try to make it believable.
I don't even know. I can't even come up with a joke because I'm so lost at this point. My mind is scrambled. I've got the Mako poisoning.
From your eyes are beautiful. Game.
You can be a soldier now, Tom. Congratulations.
Ex-soldier.
I'll make this quick. Got that much. He understands that much.
Good old what's his face. One thing you got.
I prefer the original game. In this segment, in the original game, you went up in the rafters of the church and dropped barrels on guys.
He's not even kidding.
No.
Like, kind of like Donkey Kong. This is a little too, like, like everything else in the game where people are just like being cool and swinging swords.
Yeah.
I guess quit being so negative. I'm sorry, guys. The world doesn't need that negativity right now. Let's focus on the positive.
Right?
Oh, God, the ghosts. What?
Listen, we're positive about Golden Compass. We can be positive about this.
Yeah, but that game was fun.
That was fun. Remember the monkey?
No, oh, no, it wasn't. That game was not fun. All right, they might drop barrels here. We don't know yet.
I hope so.
That's true. Maybe the ghosts will do it. You're not attacking. I'm okay with that, too.
Are the ghosts Turks? I'm very confused.
Come on. No, the Turks are... That Rufus there with the red hair was a Turk.
Yeah. Reno.
There's the bald guy. Yeah, not Rufus. I'm sorry. Rufus is the president's son. The bald guy, I think his name is Bull.
Rude. His name is Rude.
It's Bull, right? He was a bailiff.
Ah, okay. It's maybe a night court joke.
Yeah, night court. Only really for Anthony.
Man, show holds up.
Oh, yeah.
Hey, you okay?
Probably.
Night court and the mummy. They all hold up.
So much as a scratch on her.
One of my quarantine shows has been Cheers. It's been fun.
It's a great one. One piece. You'll lose interest around season 4.
That's about where I lost interest.
Yep.
Run.
First 2 seasons are great, though.
Coach forever.
Yep.
Drop the barrels, Cloud.
Oh, chandelier, not as good.
No. At least they like got the spirit of it.
Right. Like, listen, we should drop something right now.
This guy can't figure out how
to play. I know, he's having some problems.
Ugh. Let's just make it so much worse.
There were barrels in this church in the first game?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. So many barrels, Tom.
Filled with holy water or something?
It's just sawdust, I think.
It's not holy water in this universe. It's holy materia.
Got it. We are out. Beginner's luck. More of those things.
It's like they're guiding us.
Stay close.
So cool. There.
Need to stay ahead of them.
Prep for exfil.
Or not.
What do you think all the ghosts are? Does anybody have any theories yet?
Probably like the life stream or something.
Ugh, you're probably right.
I think that they're all the Patreon donors.
Yeah. I think
everybody that donated to the Kickstarter of the game.
Yeah.
Let's just go. Okay. Up for crossing the rooftops? See that pillar over there? There's a station right by it. Shall we mosey on over?
It's pretty old.
Oh, yeah. Cloud said, let's mosey. Do you remember he said that in the game?
Yeah, I do.
Easy now.
You worry too much. I'm not some princess who needs to be coddled. Shit.
All right, that's the Kotaku article. It's so important.
That's the one there she says the bad word, huh? That's
There was a Polygon article that said that was important, right? Or something. Yep.
Thank you, Cloud.
It shows that she's not a princess. I know they just told us she's not a princess. That showed us. It reinforced the point.
You know, I thought about leaving once.
That's good storytelling. That's what I have to say.
In the end, I couldn't.
You know what they say. Show and tell.
Mm-hmm. I thought Barrett was a prince until I saw his gun arm, so.
Maybe more than I can handle, I think, sometimes.
Makes sense.
What if it just shot crowns and scepters? That would be cool.
People hate the steel sky. Slums,
and gilded cups.
But I don't.
Then he could be both.
I wish it shot Oreos.
All those dreams. Flowing and blending together.
Man.
Into something greater.
Hold on. She's explained the something. And it didn't seem important. It seemed important for a second. Then I'm like, maybe not.
This part isn't important. We're all just waiting for the freaking honeybee in.
Yes. Yeah, I know. Yes. He's right. Yes. He's 100% right.
Is that coming up soon, for real?
I think...
Well...
I don't know past this point.
No. Because from here... No, yeah, it would be, because Tifa gets taken on the cart from here, right?
Yeah.
Like, you see Tifa go by. Maybe she's wearing a cowboy hat again.
But we don't know what they injected in between that to pad things out.
Not really.
Cloud might have to do 50 side quests.
Thanks
That's true. Because the scene that just happened actually takes place at the park in the original game, I think. And then Tifa goes by.
To the station.
Unless that wasn't the scene that I just saw. And this is just a new scene.
A few monsters on the way. There's a face that screams, so what?
She's talking about me?
She's got you pegged.
Oh?
Judge, you know what's happening on the internet. Have the regular Final Fantasy speedrunners started playing this game yet? The original like Final Fantasy VII speedrunners?
People try to speedrun like day zero.
Right, I know. But like have like the, who's the muscle guy that plays the
Caleb?
Man? Yeah, he plays the Final Fantasy. He speedruns this, right? Or speedruns the original game. Like,
yes.
Do you see those guys out there trying to...
What's going on with that guy's hair?
speed run it?
Got a good view of the reactor.
I don't know. I've kind of fallen out of that scene, unfortunately. I know, very unfortunately.
They know that. I want to know, like, their takes, like the people that have played the original game, like.
They don't have opinions or like any sort of brains, let's say, because like, they just
repeat inputs.
Yes, exactly, Anthony. They're just like morons. They're just like, yeah, pretty good, you know. I liked it.
It's all about inputs.
I like when Rude came out of the helicopter. That was cool. I went Bull from Night Court. Came out of the helicopter. It's pretty cool.
Thank you.
Let's go.
Nobody told me how he meant no.
Deal or no deal.
Wait, is that Pitbull?
Mr. Worldwide.
A real man on a mission. Think of other bald guys, quick. Paul Schaefer.
Ooh, that's a good one.
Bald guys with sunglasses and a beard, though, is what you gotta. Like a pencil thin beard.
Then, let's stick to the back streets? Ah. There will be monsters.
The inferior sequel to There Will Be Blood.
Man, that movie holds up too.
I agree.
Still a fair ways off.
Well, we did take a detour. Getting tired?
No.
People live here? Good lord.
I'm feeling a bit hungry. How about you?
Amazed.
I hope there's a sandwich minigame. We make it back.
Don't have time for that.
You'll want to make time for my mom's cooking.
Cloud's got to do squats for a sandwich.
We'll get home quick and eat ourselves stupid.
I wonder. Oh boy, I wonder what kind of games they're gonna have for the mini games to get the clothes for the honeybee in. So Wutai. Wait,
they're trying to frame Wutai for the terrorists. They're saying that Avalanche is a bunch of Wutai terrorists, so they can perform a false flag operation and go to war.
There's Scarlet. Look at her.
Yeah, what a babe.
Can you give us any updates on the status of the reactor? What kind of damage?
What is the dress code at Shinra HQ? Because Heidegger wears like a Russian military man. She wears like a ball gown or something.
It's got a collar on it though. That's cool.
Listen, we want to show that in 2020 we respect women by making Tifa's boobs slightly smaller, but also we're going to show you this lady's cleavage, which is out of control.
She's a bad person.
Where?
Her cleavage is really important. I'm going to tell you why, because it shows that she's not a princess.
Oh, okay, gotcha. It's all coming together now.
And then, you know, the Vice President Rufus, he's wearing like a lab coat or something like that. Nothing makes any sense in this damn company. No wonder they're going down the tubes. And my 401k suffers.
Have no fear. Shinra will keep Midgar safe.
Did she kick the camera?
Yes, man, I kicked. Certainly I'm a trustworthy source.
Cool, that was basically a wrestling promo.
I'll see you, Cloud, at WrestleMania.
They're all the same to me.
Huh. You sure you want to say that to a florist?
Better than lying.
Okay, then what'd you do with the flower I gave you?
Oh
boy.
I did.
Ooh, to who? Tell me.
Don't recall.
Poof. What? Ouch. Gave it to Tifa.
You didn't like
He's keeping his options open.
Yeah, smart.
Well, anyway.
I hope this guy plays it so that we can go on the date with Barrett at the Golden Saucer. That's the way to play.
I think he already screwed that up.
Ah, farts.
Let's be honest, they're not getting to the Gold Saucer.
Yeah, they're never getting there. We're never getting off the first continent. In this remake series.
This game is selling well.
It's going to end on the boat.
Let me tell you about Shenmue 1, Anthony. That's
touche.
They had seven.
This guy knows stuff about video games. The real historian over here.
Yeah, I'm teaching you.
Oh, appreciate it.
There's countless examples of first games in a seven game series that sold well. You know, you got the Shenmues, you got the Dot Hacks, you got the Xeno Sagas.
Yep.
And then it turned out the sequel didn't, and then they rushed it all, and then they made a third game that just, you know, had everything shoehorned into it.
Yep.
Come on.
That's what's going to happen here.
I hope you're wrong.
So first
game, I want to watch another 12 hours of this.
First game will be all of Midgar. Second game, they'll get to the Junyan Canyon. And the third game will be the entirety of the rest of the game, but only like with two cities.
Really just cram it all onto the last disc and hope for the best.
Yep.
Real Xenogears
situation. That's my prediction.
That's my job.
Yeah, I could see that happening.
Or was my job.
The internet will be furious, but they'll buy it anyway.
No, the internet will stop caring. That's what will happen.
No one will learn a lesson. It'll be great. I can't wait. Then I'll show
you the way. By then, the kids will be, you know, like, we'll be in our 50s and...
Oh, God, I can't wait. I'm going to have so much vacation time when I'm in my 50s.
Yeah. The kids will be all clamoring for the Turks, or not the Turks, the Minecraft remake.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, that's what...
Oh, man, I can't wait for that.
And you're going to be scrolling through YouTube and four punks are going to be talking over some Minecraft remake.
A chilling vision of the future. But
why not wait until tomorrow? If you head out now, it'll be dark when you... You'll turn on retro gaming on Twitch, it'll all be Fortnite.
Yeah. When you'll have people be waxing poetic about how good we had it during the coronavirus. Mm-hmm. Oh man, it's gonna be awesome. I can't wait.
EDM Jesus will be out there talking about great games you can get for your PS3. Since we have a little time before dinner,
you should come with. That wasn't the deal.
You mean you want more? Even though you've got a priceless reward coming your way? Do you know what I promised him?
I'll do it.
I'll go grab the baskets. Be right back.
She promised him a free oil change coupon.
That's a good reward, honestly. You
take this one. Take it.
Take the damn basket, Cloud. Jeez.
Off we go.
Oh, they're gonna go pick flowers.
Mm-hmm.
You know, Judge asks, what are they gonna cram between, in between, you know, the
get that big radish. That big radish looks good. I'd pick that.
So if anyone had a flower picking,
you're the winner.
You're the winner.
You get a coupon for a free oil change. Congratulations.
All right, so let's just give this the old skip-a-rooney here.
Yep, I think that's wise.
Oh, no, Sephiroth.
Whoa, what happened?
It's always another vision in his head. Who cares? All right, come on. Oh, that dude's back. Yeah, okay.
Yep.
You just skipped ahead an hour.
That's fine, honestly.
And we're still here.
Hold on.
What?
Hold on. Oh, my God. Show that shot of Root again.
Hello, Aerith.
What do you want?
I'll see if I'll pause it if I catch it. I
haven't seen him before.
There. You barely see it. He has a wallet chain, boys.
Yes.
Wow. Does he have a studded belt, too?
They don't call him rude for nothing.
Oh, yeah.
Real rude boy.
Why he gotta be so rude?
He's my bodyguard.
Oh, he's got two wallet chains, you guys. He's got two.
I counted three, actually.
Wow.
See?
Is he the one who beat up
Reno? Oh, you're right. It is three. Wow, I feel
that like or real. Candy what? Bracelets. I'm not sure.
Need to cross my T's, dot my I's.
This is what I'm doing. Square's just the worst.
They missed a worst. Boomer joke here, like dot your T's and cross your I's. Really get the boomer demo.
Like their idea of cool is like so not mine.
No, I'm not bad.
And so it just never plays well.
The Japanese ideal of a bad guy is somebody who doesn't do his homework on time.
Well, then I'm one bad mother trucker in Japan.
You're like, you're what they call the Oni. Sucks.
Yeah. School sucks. Homework is for losers.
It is. That's why I grew up, so I wouldn't have to do homework no more.
School's so unimportant, they canceled it for the rest of the year.
They finally realized it's worthless.
So all you kids out there, listen up. Don't go to school.
Listen.
Fred says school is fun.
Like, no. Oh my god, cool. Whoa, cool.
That was if you're cool. Smart, intuitive, or ruthless, you'll succeed. Otherwise, you're screwed. You don't need to school.
He's got another pair of sunglasses.
He's always prepared. That's his second form is when he uses a second pair of sunglasses.
Leave us alone.
God.
He takes out his wallet chains. He's like, I have multiple wallet chains.
Goes into his breast pocket, pulls out another wallet chain, reattaches it.
Oh, his ringtone is the...
It's like the 20th time the victory theme has been referenced.
Yeah, it's like that's the only song in Final Fantasy. It's the only one they can reference. God, so if we reference another song, no one will know what we're talking about. No one will get the joke.
He should have had the original Turks theme as his reference, as his song.
That would be cool.
Ringtone. So they have smartphones in this universe. Do they have social media, you think? Like Shinra book or something?
I believe there is a plot point in Final Fantasy Advent Children, which again I haven't seen, but I've read about, where like Cloud doesn't have a cell phone and they all make fun of him.
He's got a flip phone still.
Yeah. Like, I legitimately think that's a plot point in Final Fantasy Advent Children. I might be wrong. They might eat me alive in the comments about it, but I feel like I read about that somewhere.
The Final Fantasy goons will get you.
Yep. I have it coming.
Let me pause the recording just so you make sure that it recorded. Okay. Playing again. And we shall resume now.
Got a little sidetrack. There we go.
Dinner's ready, in case you're wondering.
Ah, great.
Passive aggressive mom.
Sit down. I want you to make up the guest room.
Gotcha. Take a load off.
No hanky panky.
She's gonna tell Cloud about Aerith.
It's a really weird animation.
Her mom gonna hit on Cloud now?
Cool.
Judging by those eyes, I'm guessing you're a soldier.
Here it comes.
Ex-soldier.
I hate to.
You know, us older women get lonely sometimes. Without any fuss, no questions.
You boys made a trip. We don't. Do we meet Aerith's mom in the previous version of this game?
This happens. She explains where Aerith came from.
Okay. Now, I hope you're hungry. Really takes away some of the mystique, though, huh?
It's like a really long, boring exposition piece in the original game, from my memory. It might have only been like 5 minutes, but in my mind, it was long.
I've never been so proud.
Cloud's mom.
The man you've become. Women must be hounding you day and night.
That's a weird thing to say, Mom.
You know, there's all kinds of temptations in the big city.
Yeah.
I'd feel a lot better if I knew you'd found a good girl. One who'd make sure you didn't get into trouble.
This is a weird conversation, Mom.
Okay.
Mom.
An older, more mature girl. I can keep you on the straight and narrow and tell you when you're being a silly goose.
Oh. My wife tells me that all the time.
Yeah. Tom's wife just hopes he settles down and finds a good woman who can take care of him.
You know, they say every man wants to marry his mother.
Don't want to overstay my welcome.
I don't have a follow-up, I'm just saying.
No, it's just what they say. So, that is what they say.
I'll get to Sector 7.
It's simple enough. Just cut through Sector 6.
They're numerical.
It's exactly safe, but you should be okay, seeing as you're a soldier.
That answered none of my questions. Thank you, though.
Me. You'll never talk to Aerith again. Please.
You got it.
Thank you.
Oh. Ah, what a pushover.
Well, look who it is. Talk about a coincidence.
What are you doing here?
Waiting.
Why?
Because I'm not sick of you yet.
Lead on, then.
The town that never sleeps. Oh, great. What future event is going to be spoiled this time?
God, I hope it's Kate Sith. God, I hope it's Kate Sith.
I hope it's the ending to Final Fantasy VIII. You just see Squall.
Yeah. Man, you think you got some long cutscenes here. Oof.
I had a vision of a stupid cat that rode a Moogle for some reason. And we let it into our party.
And then he turned out to be like working for the enemy, but we said, that's okay.
That's all right,
we like instantly forgave him for it. and continue to let him be in our party?
He's got a pseudo-gambling mechanic. We all love it.
Or any of the slums.
The original game wasn't perfect by any means.
But he said it.
I'm surprised they didn't use the visions for some product placement. They could have put some cup noodles advertisements in there.
Cup noodles, man. All right, guys, I gotta go. I'm really hungry for cup noodles now. Money was flowing. And if only I could chop up some Marlboro or something and put them in, that would be delicious. No, there isn't any.
Right. Cloud has a vision of like the dust bunnies, and then it's like, have you, our loved one, experienced mesothelioma thanks to the dust bunnies in this game? You may be entitled to financial compensation.
Midgar is riddled with asbestos. No better way to
deal with it. Call the laws, the law offices of Raspberry, Raspberry, and Raspberry. That's the last name of a character in this game, Jesse Raspberry.
Yeah.
One that tragically doesn't go through Wall Market, and it's just through this tunnel here. At least it was back when I was a kid.
I think you're gonna fight the house soon.
No.
Man, I can't wait.
You're right.
Yeah.
Am I kidding? That's at least 5 hours from now.
They had to establish the backstory of the house for half an hour. You had to see the house being assembled by Shinra.
The house's mom has to ask if it could settle down and find a nice girl house.
What the hell is this arm? Is that what? Like construction, they don't have.
I don't know.
Like bulldozers and stuff in their world.
They're giant gloves.
Yeah. It's got big Super Smash Brothers style.
That's honestly the best thing I've seen in this game so far. That's real world building for me.
At least it's unique, yeah. Like.
Cloud's like me. He doesn't high five.
Oh no! Look. Judge is a real fist bump guy.
No, God. The boomers at work love that. They're like, dude, good one. And then they hold up like their palm to your face. Boomers love that.
They do love that.
Oh, yeah.
Sorry if you're a boomer out there. And just speak like the boomers around here. You're a cool boomer if you watch us. Anybody
around? Not like those stodgy old boomers the judge knows.
Oh, yeah.
That's been a developing storyline since we left the public eye.
Yeah,
it's really the limelight.
We are mad at the boomers always. I don't know why. Besides, but I am too. Here, boys. Caught us some burglars. What is this?
What the hell is this, Team Skull?
Oh, that guy said shit. That's how you know he's not a princess.
Yeah. I like this quasi reggae beat.
It's from the original game.
It's good.
It's like the Wall Market theme.
Oh, is it?
Yeah. For damages. Oh yeah. It's like Remix though.
It's very out of place stylistically, but that's fine. We haven't done anything wrong. Yeah, we were just passing through. Nah, I'm getting it now.
Likely story. Yeah, okay. They added like a reggae.
Like, yeah, like it's a strange choice. I didn't know Chris was in this game. Hey,
boy, these guys are funny. All right, how far ahead do I need to skip?
Oh no, I want to see these guys. Don't skip.
Oh,
I'm enjoying them. They're new. I need to know who they are.
You think that motorcycle guy is going to come back? I like that guy.
I guess they're dead.
Cloud killed him.
Yeah, he cut him in half.
With his enormous sword.
Huh? Wait a minute. Did you it's the music.
The music's good.
Yeah, it's kind
of of course.
This is a banger. What happened?
That sounded pretty good, actually.
Oh, she wants a high five. You got to give her a high five.
Here it comes.
Here it comes.
You can do it, Cloud. Do it,
Cloud. Yeah!
That was good, too. I like games with high-five mechanic.
Mm-hmm.
All right, there it is.
Here we go. To Sector 7.
Ah, the Garfield thing.
How do we open it?
More you always likely. Felt that How about we take a break? That Sound good? Igloo slide thing looks like Garfield.
Like Garfield.
Mm-hmm. It's got like a cat face.
And it hates Mondays and loves lasagna.
Man, me too.
You know, they sneak a Garfield into every Final Fantasy game.
Wedge, Biggs, and Garfield.
It's like the disgruntled Disney there it is. Animators.
You see
it? Oh, yeah? Yeah.
They're also on top of one. There are two Garfields.
No, one's name is Nermal.
Ah, yes. Virgin.
So dude, Cloud's got to be so nervous right now.
Yeah. Class, right? She's going to have to take a selfie and he'll do the hover hand. It's going to be great.
She's yeah, like, you used to be a soldier, right? He's like, yes!
Hey, listen, we've all been there, guys. Let's not give Cloud too much of a... The first
guy oh, yeah. This is, I mean... It's a coming-of-age story.
Mm-hmm.
What's his name? I probably know him.
Did she say it?
Or it yet? Looked like it.
Voldemort. Okay?
Wow. Your eyes.
Oh. It's because of the mock.
That is really Garfield-esque.
It is. It's more Heathcliff, if you ask me.
Yeah, I agree with Anthony.
Well, don't even start that. Sorry. I cannot have a Heathcliff versus Garfield debate. Not tonight.
I'm not debating it. I'm just saying it looks more like Heathcliff.
Just telling you a fact, Tom.
You want to talk about facts?
I mean, Heathcliff is not better than Garfield. I'm not going to do that. I'm not doing that angle.
I mean, if you want to go... by which had the better 90s cartoon theme than Heathcliff, but no, Garfield all the way. Come on,
that's like 80% of the debate.
Yeah, no, I mean Garfield is way better, unquestionably.
But what about Fuzzy? How do we feel about him? This is the passageway. Is that his name?
Did he ever have a cartoon? He's just in the newspapers, though, right? Nobody reads those.
That's what I thought we were talking about those. The funniest.
Oh, no, no, no. We're talking about the 90s cartoon version.
That's what I like. You know, Mary Worth, Sally Forth.
Ooh, oh, yeah, Sally Carol Forth Burnett.
You know, she winks to her daughter at the end of every episode, right?
Judge and I watched a Comic-Con cosplay or something like that.
Contest. Cosplay yeah, contest. Cosplay
yeah.
Contest. And needed to get back. One of the winners went to, you know, there's like all these dwarfs and stuff, Anthony, and like
right.
the Spider-Man or whatever.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
But one of the girl that won was dressed as Carol Burnett in a curtain.
That's great. Right.
It's from a skit. Yeah.
From the Gone with the Wind skit.
Yeah.
The Carol Burnett show.
Classic.
This was in 2019. And she looked like she was maybe like 22 years old.
Right. You know, I
mean, the Carol Burnett show really resonated.
Do you think
resonated?
Just like a bunch of nerds were afraid that they're like, oh, I don't get this reference, but I'm going to vote for it because this seems good.
Maybe. Oh, hold on. We're going to see what Tifa, yeah. Let's see what she's looking like. Cowboy? No cowboy? No.
Ooh, yeah.
Oh, boy.
Cloud, you're alive.
Oh, boy.
I thought we'd lost you.
What's going on?
Just jump over the thing. Anything later.
But now I'm on my way to see Don Corneo.
Yes,
we should
yes.
head back to Seventh Heaven, meet up with the gang.
Just jump over the frickin' railing.
I'll be fine. You've seen how much ass I can kick?
Mm-hmm.
I have.
All right. I had to discuss the deepest lore. This is going to be my only opportunity to talk about this. So I read this theory like a couple of years ago, and it like blew me away with how deep the writing in this game is. So this is a big spoiler, but I don't care.
With the remake, with the original game.
With the original game, yes.
Okay.
So there's like a fake love triangle going on here, where like Cloud, like and Aerith are kind of dating, but like Tifa is like in the mix too.
Right.
So this whole time,
and Jesse now.
Wow. All right, I'm talking about the original. All right, I'm a purist. I'm a purist. So, Tom, they're never going to get to this, so it doesn't matter. But Cloud is having like an identity crisis. He thinks that he's somebody else at this point in the story, a guy named Zach.
What?
Yes. So a little while ago, Cloud asked Aerith, like, what was the guy's name? And she said Zach, but it was blanked out in Cloud's head because, you know, we had to make everything up to 11 in the remake. Yep. So he's like, oh, God, I can't hear that name.
Now I bet you're wondering, Tom, what's the difference between Cloud and Zach? They're exactly the same. One has brown hair, though.
Okay.
It's like a Tyler Durden thing?
Kind of.
Kind of.
It kind of is. Except wow. Zach was a real person. So it's a long story, but like Zach saved Cloud's life, and then like Zach died, and then Cloud was like so traumatized by it, he like assumed Zach's identity. But yeah,
that's part of that flashback with the cowboy hat.
The interesting part that I read in this theory was that Aerith is the fake love interest in all of this, and she only loves Cloud because he's acting like Zach. And things are awkward between Cloud and Tifa because Cloud is acting like Zach, and like Tifa loves Cloud, the true Cloud.
Not Zach.
And that's like when the story really changes for the two of them, is when Cloud realizes that he's actually Cloud and not Zach. Right.
And that's why he's in a wheelchair, Tom.
And that is after the wheelchair part, and then they have sex underneath the airplane at that point.
That doesn't happen.
Yes, it does. That does happen in the game.
When does it happen?
Cloud and Tifa have sex under the airplane. I can't believe I'm debating this with you. It 100% does. I'm not even kidding.
When?
They have sex under the airplane.
They're both under the airplane.
Before they go into the northern crater.
No.
Yes. All right, hold on.
I'm looking it up. I should Google Tifa Cloud God sex.
Oh, no, do not Google that. Don't Google it.
Sex.
Don't Google that. Don't let your wife see you Googling it.
I don't care what she
thinks. Cloud puts it in. It's 37 minutes long.
Cloud puts it in.
It's in super slow motion.
Get it, Cloud.
How did this happen?
All right, well, it 100% happens. It 100% it's 30 minutes long, but
I believe you. I was just giving you guff. But so anyway, so they have sex under the plane.
Well, I guess the thing that was interesting to me is that I had never considered that before, and it like kind of adds a new layer to the story. And you know, people, we're cynical and we're old, we're boomers essentially, and so I wanted to just point out that like that's a nice storytelling element that like makes sense, even though Cloud and Zach aren't really that different, and the Zach that we see doesn't resemble at all the Cloud that we see, and so it doesn't make any sense for Aerith.
I
think that was probably what they're trying to go for, because Aerith is the fake love interest,
and she does, it makes sense too, because she constantly makes comments about how he like is so much like him,
right? So she's not really in love with Cloud, she's like remembering Zach.
Right. Who was her former boyfriend.
Right.
Who was an ex-soldier, if you will.
So that was it. I just wanted to pay kudos to that nerd who probably just made it up.
Yeah, it's still good. You know, that's
a good theory, though. It's fun about certainly story, plausible.
Right.
I don't know, like, what kind of theories we could have off of this game like that. we'll have to see.
The bandits, they have sex with the fat one all the time, I guess. Under the bus instead of the airplane.
Yeah. The motorcycle guy and the dog from Shinra have a spin-off TV show where they're the stars. I would watch that.
Yeah, I would too. But I'm sick.
All right. Sorry for that departure.
Oh, no, it's okay. But I mean, you make a point too. It's like, no, you can keep going. I just was going to say, like, the original game was probably written by like two guys.
Yeah.
Or is this one was written by like 70 people and it's terrible? Penny, like,
right?
Yeah. And when you get to that level, it's just like not about that anymore. And all you could really do is choreograph a cool sword fight.
Yeah.
That's like essentially a Marvel movie at that point. You know what I mean? Like, smart you think you are. He'll find a way to turn it against you. It kind of loses a lot of that and where is she going nuance in the storytelling, I feel like, when you get to a certain point.
I agree.
But I don't know. Maybe not. Maybe there's a lot of nuance in this. I'm missing it all. I'm just
trying to. You trying to trigger me with that Marvel comment, huh? Huh?
No, I wasn't. I don't like Marvel things. Sorry.
No, me too.
It's not an indictment on anybody. It's just I don't.
Yeah.
I get bored.
I agree.
Bored very easily.
I mean, I like them. Don't get me wrong. Hey there. I enjoy watching them.
You gave a ride to a girl earlier. Do you have any idea where she went?
No.
We already know.
And if you don't need a ride, then get the hell out of here. Can't you see I'm trying to work?
She told Cloud she's going.
Right.
Yeah, she literally.
That's what happens when you have 70 writers.
She could not be more direct about where she was going.